Hey guys, for my first vlog on this channel, I will be talking about the functions of the heart and why understanding these functions are important to understanding yourself. I think I don't understand myself. Anyway, coming right up.
Understanding your heart is about knowing what the three functions of the heart actually are.
I think I just hit a plan. Whatever.
So, the three functions of the heart are:
number one,
the heart helps transport.
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 This is a bad idea.
Transport
things throughout the body. I think I'm just gonna go back home. This is a bad idea, doing this outdoors.
So that was a bad idea. Hey, Aman here with Heart Limits, a channel that's dedicated to bringing you relevant facts, the proper tips and tools, and the lifestyle changes that are necessary to keep you, if you do it right, within your extended heart limits.
So after completely failing shooting outdoors, deciding to just shoot at home, well, apparently this is my home. Not that bad, right? Well, anyway, let's recap and speed things up a bit. Well, the heart has mainly three functions. You are aware that in some parts of the globe, they actually do this as three. Some people do this. They count like one, two, three, or one, two, three, one, two, it's just chaos. Anyway, number one, the heart transports things around the body with the use of blood. It can either be oxygen, which is responsible for movement. It can also be nutrients, which basically ensures that the body does not die or something. Well, at least it keeps it healthy. It's also responsible for transporting hormones so that the body will know what to do. Alright, I want this body part to do this particular thing. And lastly, it's also involved in transporting waste products. Well, waste products for the reason that it has to get out of the system eventually, right? So it can be in many forms. Liquid, solid, or gas. You can think about it in any way you want. Well, anyway. The second function of the heart, security. So security in the sense that it also serves as protection. So, you know, for foreign materials such as bacteria or even infection. It also serves as a way to create clotting mechanisms just so that shit doesn't get worse than ever. They block it out or basically create this roadblock so the body doesn't get infected or affected too much. And the third function of the heart is actually to regulate body temperature. When your blood vessels are relaxed, they're cooler. And when your blood vessels are highly contracted, it's something else. It's basically hotter. Well, let me explain. When your blood vessels are contracted in a way that there's not that much space left for delivery or for anything else, it basically heats up because the space is too small. But when it's relaxed, there's more space. Giving it more room, the cooler it becomes. So simply put, the responsibilities of the heart is, it is our logistics company. It's our protection slash security company. And it is our heating and cooling system.
Well, what can you say? Our heart is rather quite
amazing!
So, given that now that I'm home, I just decided I just sit down and make my setup much better because my arm hurts from carrying this freaking camera too long. So how does knowing the functions of the heart help you understand more about yourself? If you are giving your heart too much of a hard time performing its basic or most important functions, that means there must be something that you are doing wrong. There are a couple of things that gives your heart a hard time. Number one, being unfit and unhealthy actually gives some pressure to your heart. You should ask yourself these questions. Do you eat enough? Do you eat healthy? Are you conscious of your calorie intake? Do you work out? Do you work out the right way? And do you even work out the right amount of time? Being angry, too stressed, also even being too anxious are a couple of things that affect your heart. Do you undergo certain anger management stuff? Or do you get into meditation? Do you do yoga? Are you aware of mindfulness? You know, these things contribute to how well your heart can perform. And by taking these small steps actually is a way to caring more about yourself. Do you take certain medications? Or are you suffering a certain disease? Well, of course, when you are suffering a disease, you do require certain medications. But are you aware that some medications might have a direct impact to how your body and how your heart actually performs? Taking certain products doesn't necessarily mean it's a good thing. For short term, for long term. Some people drink too much coffee. They drink an entire pitcher even just for breakfast. Some even drink any other energy-based product just so that they feel like they can carry on with the day. You know, being reliant on products doesn't necessarily mean that you can rely on yourself on its own. Your genetics are actually involved with your heart. My parents or my parents' parents or somewhere along that line, there was a problem. Not every human being is perfect, and there are certain limitations, certain factors that you need to take into consideration. That being, if it's in your genes that your family has a line of heart problem, there are certain steps that you actually need to take. You need to be aware that you need to act at your age. You know, most people, it's true, you know, you find it fascinating when you see amazing grandma, you know, doing all these things. Like, wow, she can dance, she can break a leg. Not literally break a leg, I mean, but, you know, she can do things that just mind boggles you, you know. But on the long run, it's actually not recommended for the reason that as you age, no matter what you do, your body ages as well. When you reach a certain age, you need to be aware, and really aware, that heart disease is actually the number one cause of death. And it's been that way for about 15 years already. Imagine that, 15 straight years, and it's still the number one cause of death. By creating a checklist doesn't only help you understand where you were, how you are right now, and where you can be in the future, it helps you understand what and how much effort you actually need to put in to get into where you want to be. I, of course, am not asking you to live a boring life. That would just be sad. Well, what I'm asking you to do is to live smart and to live towards where you want to be in the future. Remember, being aware of your heart is the first step to being aware of yourself. If you like this channel, please, please don't forget to leave that like, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button. It would definitely mean the world to me. Aman here with Heart Limits, wishing you the best.